American. And 5, 4, 3, 2. What up, y'all? Welcome to Here's the Thing. I'm Kev Austin. She's
that chick, Angel.
Welcome to another podcast episode. Smash that like button. Smash that notification button. Bangers all 2022. It's a beautiful day. I got my friend's merch on.
Make them believers.
This is you. This came in my box. Is this not you?
Oh, he gave you an extra thing, no.
Oh, this ain't yours? I was like, I remember ordering this.
I would have said something by now, Kevin.
I was like, Angel didn't say nothing. I wore my shirt yesterday in my video. I didn't post it on Instagram.
Well, though, because, I haven't seen it.
That's, yeah, I did a Game of
Thrones. Nobody would know, Kevin.
I'm doing Game of Thrones recaps on my main YouTube page.
Really?
It was such a good time. Yeah.
I was about to ask if we were going to talk about it or not.
Oh, okay, no. We can.
Because it was so good.
Woo!
It
was fire. No pun intended.
And I read a really bad review on it before the episode.
Before
and
they did just, you?
Yeah, they put my hope. Hilarious. They had my expectations on the ground. They dogged the whole series.
Already?
Yeah, like I'm sure it's one of those reviews they've seen, like however many episodes into the season. And let me tell you, I was pleasantly surprised when I saw all the action, when I saw all the tea.
Oh, man.
It was so good.
Violence, sex, dragon fire, way too much blood. They went back to season one.
Let me tell you, I closed my eyes. That's what I did.
During the birth scene?
No. A little bit of the birth scene. No, during the...
The jousting scene?
Yeah.
Playing charades.
I couldn't remember what it's called. The jousting. When they were fighting during the jousting and losing their mind.
Nah, it was tough. That is a gory show.
Yeah.
That man put that axe in his face and ripped it. It was like C. They be killing people hard on C.
Speaking of C, that's the mine, ain't it?
Huh?
C.
It's
next
back?
Season?
Yeah.
You're lying.
When? It's either tomorrow or Friday.
Hold on.
The final season?
Yes.
Oh, August 26th.
See, Friday.
I didn't even know. I didn't even know.
The Game of Thrones spinoff recaps are put on hold until the C episodes are fully
with
reviewed.
Baba Voss.
Instead with Baba. Oh, shit.
Baba Voss is my guy. Yeah. All right, anyway, before we start, I need to ask you this, Angel.
What's
this was a thing on Twitter, and it made me laugh. I asked Melissa, too, but I'll tell you your answer after. Can you name me 5 current NBA players?
I'm going to name Chris Paul.
Okay.
Because my son was playing basketball with his son yesterday.
I knew you would have a reason for that. I thought you were going to say Boca Bombs or something.
No, him and Marcus was outside talking.
Okay.
So, they live out here?
Yeah, they live right over there.
Mm-hmm.
Interestingly enough, that's why I've been trying to move over there.
His in-laws live across the street from us.
Okay. More taxes.
So, Stephon Curry.
Also known as Stephen Curry.
Mm-hmm. His
that's close. For you, Asia, that might as well be it.
E or O or an A. It just rolled the dice with that
LeBron
last name.
LeBron James.
Okay,
LeBron
that's
James.
3.
All right. There's an... Okay. There's another man. He has eyebrows. Let's go. Is there an Irving of some?
Kyrie Irving?
Yes! Come on!
And eyebrows, we'll accept eyebrows.
We'll give it to her.
So let me tell you who Melissa said. The whole discussion came from Dragonfly Jones.
Oh, Blake Griffin. I know that little light-skinned black boy.
Don't help him, y'all. Get out the comments.
I didn't look at the comments, okay. But now I remember him. Uh-huh.
The whole thing was you had to do it without Googling, without looking. So Dragonfly Jones was talking about there's only probably 2 or 3 household names in basketball. He's like, if you ask anybody, like your HR lady, somebody who doesn't know sports, how many players they'll know? And he was like, they might only know LeBron and Steph Curry. So I was like, dang, let me ask Melissa. Melissa was like, LeBron James, mm-hmm. Steph Curry, Draymond Green, which I was like, how did you know Draymond? Mm-hmm. And then she did like you. After 3, she was like, okay. Then she goes, the man who got the tattoos that are hidden, and he's balding, but he still be trying to have hair.
Kevin Durant.
I said, Kevin Durant? I said, yes. Because he has, I don't know if you know, he has the whole.
Kevin Durant.
I know
him. That's fine.
He has a whole body of tattoos. And then she said, eyebrows guy. That's why I was so funny that you said eyebrows guy.
I'm the man with the eyebrows.
Okay, now two more. Can you name any current NFL players?
Yes.
Okay.
Russell Wilson.
Literally what she said. Because Sierra, the black right. woman, know Russell. Well, Melissa knows because of Seahawks.
The white dude that be cheating. They brothers. One retired.
Oh.
They be deflate the ball.
Tom Brady?
Tom Brady.
That's the Melissa's other person.
Tom Brady.
Tom Brady and Russell Wilson, she was the, that's the all she knew.
But then there's brothers. He didn't have no brothers.
Oh, the Gronkowskis?
No, I think she's talking about the Mannings.
Manning, Peyton?
Oh, yeah. He's not current, though. Neither is Eli.
One of them. The both of them retired?
They're both out, yeah.
Oh, I didn't know. Yeah. I thought they were Tom Brady.
What's crazy, I knew who she was talking about, though.
I thought they weren't Tom Brady. I know. She said deflate the ball.
Yeah, she squeezed so the air out. You can
hold it.
Deflate it.
Deflate the ball. Okay, last Grab one. Hold can you name any, and I mean one, current Major League Baseball player?
Yes.
Okay.
Pretty sure there is an Oscar Gonzalez somewhere.
They're just throwing common names from the I'm Latin. Sure
there's an Oscar Santiago.
No.
Oscar Santiago. If no. there's an Oscar Santiago.
You should have said Carlos.
Carlos Santiago.
Nope. Cargo, Carlos Gonzalez.
I know. And listen, I'm going to tell you, I can only give you about five baseball players.
I just watched the whole
bunch. I know. Actually, I probably know more. Mike Trout, Mookie Betts. I don't know if Matt Kemp is still playing. He probably out.
Oscar I don't think Santiago so.
Is he out? Shot.
he fortunately didn't play baseball though.
Shohei Ohtani, Japanese dude.
Shohei.
He be hitting homers and pitching, man, yeah, which is Angels, not common. You don't usually be hitting homers and
not
pitching.
Not that consistently. You might get one ear.
There is an Oscar Gonzalez.
Angel, of course, in baseball somewhere. You don't know that, man. Yeah. You just threw out common names.
And he's from the DR. I got that.
That's what I said. I know Fernando Tatis Jr. Mm-hmm. because when we were in San Diego, he was everywhere.
You know, he just got in trouble.
Yeah, I saw. It was a ringworm, Josh. It wasn't PED. Okay.
What bro, he has one of the biggest contracts in baseball. And he's like.
He's trying to keep it. He's trying to keep it.
I guess, man.
Manny Machado. Clayton Kershaw. Bellinger. Mm-hmm. I sound like somebody's black uncle. Who the Cody boy down for them Dodgers?
Yeah.
But anyway, the whole thing was like, and then we went to all basketball players, and Melissa could name more than I thought. But the whole argument was like, there's not that many household names, period. Most people, if you gave them, if they don't watch the sport, you gave them basketball people, they probably named Kobe, Shaq, Michael Jordan, Pippen, and then some combination of Rodman, Magic Johnson. In the entire NBA's history, most people can't name 10 people.
I can see where Steph could cross over, though. Yeah. His wife is pretty.
That's why everybody has her own name. Everybody. And people were asking their parents and their moms. It was so funny because people were
in the industry.
People were just the Mexican dude showed his parents' response, and it was like Steph Curry, LeBron James. It was just like how people talk. But anyway, I thought that would be funny. All right. I saw this yesterday, and I was upset.
I'm so sorry.
The Rolling Stones done said that Harry Edward Styles, okay, is the new king of pop. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Why were you mad?
Because no Harry, and I got nothing against Harry Edward. I really don't. I don't know much to know about Harry Edward. I could name you. He's Watermelon Sugar High Boy, ain't he?
Watermelon Sugar, yeah, I think so. High.
Yeah, he's Watermelon Sugar High Boy.
If it ain't Justin Bieber, then it's him, in my opinion. was that Justin Bieber? No, always then it's Harry.
Has Harry Styles even eclipsed Justin Bieber?
I don't know.
I think Justin Bieber's career bigger than Harry Styles.
Because you know him more. Justin Bieber be over here with us a lot of the time.
He do.
That's why
that Dog on Purpose album was... That was... all niggas in the credits.
Yeah, that he
was trying to make. He been trying to get the RBM out. We're like, boy, if you don't
get him from over here,
get your butt over here. Remember when he was in the hood doing push-ups? We're like, nigga, you gonna get killed down there with them Crips. They had him doing push-ups. Like, Justin, get out of the rolling 60s.
This will be happening.
He really was in the hoods. They had him singing and stuff. Y'all never see this video?
No, thank God.
Justin Bieber was in the hood singing and doing push-ups in L.A.
Street cred.
Yeah, we're like, boy, what is you doing down there?
Which song?
I don't remember what song he was singing. Oh. I was more impressed that he was doing push-ups. Like, who was like, hey, do some push-ups? He was
not like, gonna lie, right. Though, that, right. That Peaches NPR version, he was on to something.
I love Justin.
I'm a
big Justin fan. Now, this is why King of Pop don't fly. I feel like sometimes...
They said Harry Styles is a Jacquees of pop.
Right. Like, listen, I don't know enough about Harry. I know he probably selling some albums and doing some tours. King of Pop... You gotta at least be close to eclipsing or even in the same stratosphere to even hint at that. There's a lot of artists that Harry ain't even surpassed them.
Do you think that they were... See, this is the thing. This is the reason why I didn't take none of it. I don't think they're even referring to Michael's title of King of Pop. They're talking about some white stuff.
There is no other title.
No, because they might be talking, oh, well, it's Harry and Taylor Swift neck and neck for the king or you queen mean, of pop.
You talking about currently? Like they talking about currently?
And white people.
Who else do they have, Kevin? White people?
Yeah, I don't think they were.
You
got to
say something else.
No, they don't think they we're don't reading know. Them.
Kevin, what did they?
I don't think. I was like, oh, okay, for them, yeah.
They found out about Thames and WizKid because of Justin Bieber.
I don't think
the same demographic we're talking about.
For us.
But
for
the king
everyone.
Of pop was for everybody, though.
No, that was Elvis.
Elvis? He was the king of rock, wasn't he?
He was the king of thieves.
You're right.
Listen.
That's what I'm just saying. They got their side. Just leave them over there.
Yeah, I feel like they're not in no way, shape, or form thinking of the title of king of pop in the way that we regard Michael Jackson. Who reached everybody. While I do know black folk that rock with Harry Styles is few and far between, I think they really talking about some white people stuff. I don't. When I saw it, I was like, oh, they not talking about us.
No.
You said I ain't giving them that.
I want them to say something else. I want them to say Harry Styles, he killing right now. That's it.
That's it. That's
don't,
it.
Don't. King of Pop is the moniker for Michael. He is the king of pop. He was...
And
dare I
come.
Say, I don't think, I don't know what the world holds, but I doubt I don't think technology ever swings back to where physical copies will ever be sold.
It don't even matter about sales. Impact alone, Harry's not touching what Michael's
that's what I'm saying.
Has done.
That's the reason why I think they think white people stuff, because you know, in order for someone to get a title, especially in music, we got to have our say.
We do? Black folks?
Yeah. In order for it to be lit, black people got to say it's legit.
That's what I'm saying.
And that's why I don't think they talking about what we be talking about.
Then why they say the king of pop?
Because they
got to irritate me?
They didn't think you were going to be over there.
I don't usually be over there. I don't usually be down to the Rolling Stone.
They didn't think you were coming over there, Kevin.
They were like, what Kev doing over here in the Rolling Stone? I said, hey, heard y'all say something about some king of pop?
Yeah.
On some Harry Edward.
They were like, this is for white people anyway. That's what
But they use
that's what they
you better whisper it.
They use your clip.
You better not yell
they use
it.
Your clip and they just overdubbed the
that's
black part.
Hilarious.
Yes, that is what they were like. What is he doing over here?
I think they was trying to get us riled up, us being the people, not just necessarily me. I think, you know, they're trying to sell albums. I mean, albums. Sell magazines, trying to get clicks.
Yeah.
Because they did say, I think they said the new king of pop, and I don't even want you to say that.
Yeah,
I want you to say something else. I want you to say Harry Styles been having a lot of hits in a row.
I wonder in the article, this is what let me know whether or not I am far off or if I'm somewhere in the neighborhood of the intention. If in the article they bring up Michael Jackson.
Did they?
Then I don't know. It's not for me, Kevin.
It's for white people anyway.
This is not, they were not writing it for me to read.
Let me pull it up. Because Michael Jackson's family said he didn't earn it. But they always be on there. Paris or
But if they,
that baby.
If they are like, similar to the rise of Michael Jackson, then I'll be like, y'all, they on there on that some pure cocaine when they wrote this.
Okay. Pure.
Pure. That thing wasn't cut with nothing.
All right, hold on. Let me see.
They took the coca plant and just started chewing it directly.
Man, I saw cocaine being made on a YouTube video one time.
Oh, I thought you were about to be like, I was about to be like, well, Kevin, nah. No, don't do that.
There you go. There's a lot of deadly chemicals in there. People making it be having hazmat suits and gas masks on, and people just be like, this is fine.
Pure.
All right, let me read you the first line.
That uncut.
On a Friday night in New York, Harry Styles put on a show. Michael Jackson is trash. He was never nothing. White people are the best. I hated all his albums. Man in the Mirror is whack. Let me see if the word Michael Jackson even comes up. Somebody said
he can be the Duke of Pop.
He can be the Duke?
Listen.
The Duke of Pop.
Listen.
He can be the Duke? Harry Styles be known for his clothes a lot too, don't he? Yeah, he always be wearing something crazy.
I'm going to tell you what. Let me tell you what I know about Harry.
Actually, I can't.
If Harry walked past me on the street, I would be like, hey, don't you work at Starbucks? Like, I would not know who that baby. He could be one of the baseball players. I couldn't remember.
Sorry to this man. I don't look like she's talking about Michael Jackson. You know what? The girl riding this probably don't even know Michael Jackson. She probably Harry Styles' age. Yeah, she might not even know Michael Jackson was the Queen of Pop. I mean, I still don't forgive her.
That's what I'm
saying. She should have known.
I really don't think at the core of this was in reference to Michael. I do, because I just don't think they're thinking about us. They know that, like, we have not been out here saying, give me some of that Harry Styles, because that's not what we doing. I mean, I know my niece Victory likes Harry Styles.
Really?
That's the only reason why he does that. He has that song about food in a sushi restaurant. You know what I'm talking about, Josh?
Harry Styles, food in a sushi restaurant.
Food for a sushi. Music for a sushi restaurant.
Oh, it sounds like it should be in a sushi restaurant?
No, that's the title.
I was going to say, I don't know why you're yelling.
Oh, that's the song?
That's the title of the song, though.
Somebody.
The song is called Music for a Sushi Restaurant?
Music for a Sushi Restaurant.
The first lyrics are Baba, Baba, Baba.
The song is fire. Green eyes,
fried rice. I could cook an egg on you.
The song is fire.
I'm out.
Does it say I can cook an egg on you for real?
All my life, I'm out. Oh, we definitely gonna play.
Sorry.
Angel, it don't matter if you might as well put it in the mic.
But if I move it, it doesn't know. Come on, hurry up and get to these words.
I've never heard this in my life.
It was on my reel.
Oh, I've heard this. That's a ba ba ba.
This goes hard. Green eyes, fried rice, I cook an egg on you. Come
girl,
on.
Girl, get this out of my ear canal. He really said I can cook an egg on you.
I am out. I've never heard this
song. Is
this
song really called Music for a Sushi Restaurant?
I've literally only heard the beginning because of TikTok. Ba, ba,
ba. Mm. The bass line is fire. You. This song is actually nice. I mean, the words are crazy. Yeah, it's fire.
This was a TikTok sound. Ba, ba,
ba. Never in my life have I heard those musical notes.
If you were to just listen to it actually is a dope song. The words maybe, but if you change the words and keep the melody, I mean, but there's a whole bunch of people that we don't be liking.
No. Listen, Randy said it's not fair. You're already tainted. I like Watermelon Sugar High.
Watermelon Sugar High.
That was a TikTok song. TikTok song as well. I'm not saying Harry Styles is whack. I'm saying he ain't no king of pop.
I don't think that we have absorbed enough of his stuff to really have a fair conversation.
Then he can't be the king of pop.
I don't think it's for us.
He in the realm of pop.
He's their king. He
is this your king, White?
You know who would probably have a better conversation about them is Rap Radar.
That's true.
Have you heard of that podcast before? It's with Elliot Wilson and Ryan B. Dot.
Yeah.
B. Dot Miller.
They have B. Did I say it wrong? B. Dot.
B. Dot.
That's what I said. Brian B. Dot Miller. They be bringing real, like, definitive conversational music and culture with the biggest names in hip hop, though. That's mostly where they be at, which is not a conversation I can typically have, because if you ask me to name 5 to 10 current rappers, Oscar Gonzalez is going to be in there as well. Now it's at, now this podcast is at his new home, Interval Presents, for the first time. Rap Radar is available on every platform, so you can listen now on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, Stitcher, or wherever you get your podcast. So,
wait, is that
check
B-D-A-H-T?
Huh?
No, B dot.
No, B dot.
B dot D-O-T. They have,
oh, that B dot.
Yeah. B dot dot.
There's a lot of B dots. There's that B dot. There's B dot the basketball. There's B dot the comedian.
8.5, remember?
Yeah.
But we talking about the B dot on
Rap Radar.
Rap Radar.
Radar.
Not to be confused with the other B dots.
Yeah. Now on to the show.
Nice.
But yeah, Harry Styles. I don't know this baby.
I don't know this baby.
But I like the sushi restaurant song.
I never
Green
heard it.
Eyes, white rice, I can cook an egg on you.
Before we get to our next topic, I just want to say something funny. I have forgotten I had this video with Will Smith from the Oscar
you
day.
You forgot.
I totally forgot I had it. I was That's going crazy. Through my phone, deleting stuff, and I was like, oh, snap, I never posted this. And I just posted it. I don't know how it slipped.
The timing is crazy.
It's ridiculous.
When you posted it to Will Smith's return to Instagram. I was just thinking about that this morning
Kevin
when I was driving.
Kevin doesn't forget anything.
I was like, what are the odds?
I said, what?
Because Kevin, Angel, if I'm wrong, Kevin normally posts immediately.
He doesn't normally, wait for anything. Which is
Kevin,
why this was so surprising.
Kevin usually posts before he's recorded the video.
Right. Most of the time.
I don't even understand how he would have waited this long.
It didn't make any sense. The day of the Oscars would have been the perfect day to post a video with Will Smith.
But there was just so much hullabaloo.
Especially after he won his award.
Right. Yes. Because, well, I would have, but I went to the governor's ball, danced.
Oh, you drank.
And then I had some champagne. I fell asleep.
Wow.
And, you know, the next day I'm just posting. It gets further up your videos.
You forgot about Will Smith.
I know.
I forgot.
He forgot about Willard Smith. Oh,
so
no.
What's funny is about this is I think something happened that night. He watched an Oscar. I don't know. He was crying. And all these comments on this video where we walked through what the video would be and how he would look and how he would walk up and all that. Everybody's a body language expert now. All the comments, you can see it in his eyes. He was already on edge. What you got? Yes, Angel,
what?
On all my platform. Now I see what happened. Look at the furrow in his brow. He was already, I said,
he was on that stuff.
Y'all don't know nothing.
I love it.
Y'all, we done planned this video. It went approved through the. You don't just get Will Smith on the Oscar carpet by happenstance. Wow. And that's how I tell. The internet don't know nothing, but you can't tell them that they don't know.
I want to start being these people. They, you know, I rarely, unless I have something funny to say or unless it's emojis, fire emoji, big heart
high
eye
emoji, high five emoji,
high five emoji, smile, laugh, LOL emoji. Unless it's that or a funny comment, I typically don't comment on many things. But there are people who really be wanting to, like, add their 2 cents, which is fine. I mean, discussions and comments can be great. But the people who have, like, really visceral, like, I need to put a weight on it, I have never understood it. But I feel like I'm going to start a fake Instagram account just so I can start doing that. It'll be like Not That Chick Angel or something like that. So
something very inconspicuous. You have no idea the relationship.
That chick devil.
Right. Just so I can start doing stuff like that. I want to feel what that's like.
That bird. Not a chick. It's a bird.
That bird. Ain't that hen devil. They'll never know.
No one will put two and two together. Mm-mm. And I just laugh because it reminds me of all the other times on the internet where people don't have the whole story or piece of the story. And also, had the Oscars not went that way, like maybe if he didn't win the Oscar, no one would ever have ever thought that. When something is framed for you, your mind goes with the framing.
That is what I was telling you about the whole acting thing. I think I forgot what the effect is called. But a lot of time in film acting, more so than stage. So in stage acting, the actor is responsible, plus lighting and sound, you can add soundtrack, for taking the audience on the emotional ride of the story, right?
Yeah.
Because there's nothing to cut it and reframe it, right?
Yeah.
But in film, you can have an actor do a face that is almost emotionless. It could literally be.
Yes, I remember you told me this. It was so good.
They could do, where's that? The face Sing could literally around, be.
Oh my God.
Wow.
And I'm gonna put that emotion on you.
Right, right.
She got a fart.
She got, it's in there. I could be looking out a window like this. Now, if the scene after you see my face looking like this is a child maybe getting hit mm-hmm. by a car, maybe, you're gonna think I am stunned.
Yes.
If it's my husband coming home from the war, you're gonna think I'm in shock, but in good shock.
Yeah.
Like, oh, she can't believe the love of her life is coming. We can add so many things, or an editor, director can add so many elements around this one face that is actually, I'm actually looking at a wall and Anything. Thinking, what do I want to paint my kitchen?
Same inner monologue.
Same face. But you know, people will add in their own inner monologue.
Now take the scene before and the scene after, or add music.
Oh, we didn't.
Now you done created a whole thing. I saw this thing Tony Robbins said. They did this study in the park, right? They walk up to you, right? The person that you don't know say, hey, could you hold my cup of coffee real quick? I just got to jot something down. You hold the cup of coffee for 30 seconds. They say, thank you. Walk away, right? 30 minutes, and then another person, like they go up to Josh and they say, hey Josh, could you hold my iced tea real
yes,
quick?
Yes, of course, yes.
I'm gonna just write something down. He holds it. 30 minutes later, they come to you and ask you to read a short story about the main character. I mean, a short story, and tell you how you feel about the main character. It was like somewhere between 80 and 90%. The people who had the coffee would say the main character was warm, vibrant, they liked him. The people who held something cold would say the main character was cold, distant, and not like him. Just from what they held, subconsciously, they've been framed. They're not even connecting it to that.
Yeah.
So the internet, it's just so funny how people work. And this is why they say, like, eyewitness testimony doesn't work, because you don't see what you thought you saw. You're framed by what you think and your own interpretation, right? If I had did a video with Chris Rock, people would have said the opposite of Will Smith. He knew something was coming. Look at that. It just looks unsure.
There was so much hope in his eyes at first.
So anyway, back to this topic about music. Totally random. Me and my wife watched Shania Twain documentary the other night.
Oh, yeah, that's what she said.
Boy, when I tell you, I didn't know. I knew Shania Twain was big because she was a country star that crossed over.
Yeah, she's...
That sings like a woman or something like a woman?
Feels like
Man,
a woman.
Feel like a woman.
Let me tell you what. One thing about black folks, they rock with Shania Twain.
She's the truth.
The long way.
Yeah.
Some would say the F's with her the long way.
They come on.
And some would cuss. Not me, Kevin. Did you know
what was that,
that Shania Twain's
that didn't make it a guy.
Come On Over album sold 40 million copies? It is in the top five of all albums ever sold. Michael Jackson's at 70. The Eagles, I believe.
Yeah, that album flew.
Yeah, I actually in my mouth.
It might be two Eagle albums. Let me double check. Mm-hmm. Hold on. Michael Jackson, AC/DC, number two. That's who I forgot.
AC/DC.
Whitney Houston, the Bodyguard.
Come on, because that thing
so
was
so crazy. Pink Floyd, the Eagles, Shania Twain.
So the Eagles are a people.
Pink Floyd, was that the album that had The Wall?
No, that was Dark Side of the Moon.
Oh, okay.
Dark Side of the Moon.
The Wall.
Did you know that she sold 40 million?
I did not know.
Did you know that Shania Twain is the only artist ever in the history of music, man or woman, Michael Jackson included, to have three diamond albums in a row?
Three
diamond albums, period.
Shania's fire.
She's the queen of pop.
That's what I'm saying.
Best country.
Country pop. Crop. She's the queen of that. I said, now listen, Shania got about 3-4 songs that the boy Kev, let me tell you what, you want to hear?
I know, that's why I'm pulling up.
Hold up,
song.
This is my Shania
Feels like
Twain
a woman.
Song. Listen, I didn't even change the word.
Oh.
Come on, Kev.
But this one, when I worked at the bank, this burned up the airway. This is my. That's it.
listen. Oh, we there.
Yeah.
We'll never make it. But you look at us going on. Holding strong. We're still together. Still holding strong.
Come on.
You're still the one that I love. The only one I dream. Oh.
Come on, Tina. Steal the word.
And I love the only one I dream. Steal the one I kiss. Good night.
Now, let me tell you what about Shania Twain. We're going to play a couple more of her hits. So, her first album, she had no creative control over at all. But she got all the creative control over her music videos. She came out with the midriff. She came out with all the visuals. She was all like lush and flowy. Mm-hmm. And the video made the song go crazy, so much so that they gave her like control of her music.
Wow.
Right? After that. I didn't realize gay people really, like the gay community really rocks with Shania Twain. This is what the documentary said. Mainly because of her fashion. And I thought about that. That don't impress me much. Video.
That don't impress me much.
With the leopard. You talk about, I knew all these songs. This was big.
This was big, bank, bank.
Big
playlist.
Lobby of the Bank energy.
Man. Oh, think you're special. Oh, think you're something good.
Okay. So you're a rocket scientist.
That don't impress me much.
Got the touch. Don't get it wrong. Everything is all right.
Keep me up in the middle of the night.
Head to toe leopard print, Angel.
Impress me much.
I want you to do that character.
What?
That one.
Yeah. Yeah. That don't impress me much.
Listen, this girl had hits. Hold on, what's the other one I want?
Just in case.
What's the one? That, what's her
and the
big,
thing is,
big
it
one?
Was everything. She never sang Josh's too song. Hard. She never sang
a yeah. This outfit, too?
I don't remember her clothes. I'm so sorry.
Angel, you do. You see.
Whoa,
oh,
watch
it.
You know this. This is Lexington's finest.
Yeah.
Not them sodas going, Josh. This is the part right here.
Come on.
To the liquid there. To the liquid there.
The church, going skirt. To the pad down. I feel like a woman. And she was never singing really hard.
Nah. Let me ask you something. This documentary had me and Melissa ask this question. Do you think because of the era we grew up in, right? 80s, 90s, where it was like radio was king before streaming. We were talking about this. Melissa was like, I feel like our generation knew more music from outside of our demographic.
I think it's because of radio.
Because of radio.
Yeah.
And we were saying because of streaming, you streaming algorithms tend to serve you the music you like and not the music you don't like. So we knew like Hanson, Garth Brooks, Dido, Nirvana. Like if it was a popular song, and I also feel like top 40s radio was more of a thing.
You were in Seattle or in Washington, right?
No, we were everywhere. We were all
radio
on
the South
basis.
Is completely different than the West Coast.
Is it?
Wait, like the marketing of radio in the South is...
Yes, I can attest to
that
from when I moved.
That's true urban radio, quote unquote. The South radio.
Oh, okay. Like urban meaning black?
Yeah.
Yeah. We grew up everywhere. By the time I was in Washington, it was already almost the 2000s. Mm-hmm. I was in El Paso for most of it, then Virginia, then North Carolina.
I'm not surprised that you know a lot of Shania Twain growing up in El Paso.
Yeah.
El Paso, Texas.
Did you know a lot of other artists like Dido and Nirvana and all that stuff? Like, what's that Nirvana song? Smells Like Teen Spirit?
How'd it go?
I don't know what the words are.
Some words.
Jay-Z said it. This is like the first guitar you learn.
That's what it's
1, 2, 3. Oh, I was all over this.
I wasn't even in Washington when this came. See, you do know it.
I said, give me words. This is what they played at the skating rink.
Really?
Yeah. All my rock comes from the skating rink.
He looks so sad.
Especially, pour some sugar on me.
Jam. My jam.
Skating rink.
This is how the rock drummers are. They always gonna do it.
Yeah, it's gotta look like Bam Bam.
And looking left and right. You see old Blink-182 Travis Barker era?
The what?
Travis Barker in his Blink-182 era with his hair and everything. Oh, man.
And we're all there.
And we're all there.
Angel, you listen to Creed? Did you listen to Creed?
I don't. They all were the same.
Oh, Creed!
Come on, Kev.
What they sing?
We are not monetizing a penny on this episode.
What is that? This is Creed.
Pull that guy's TikTok up.
What if we just sang like?
Ooh, what is Creed?
Oh, I want to find that TikTok.
I bet you heard this, Angel. I bet black folks be knowing this. This is kind of like in the Nickelback era.
Yeah.
This was Rob Hopkins.
Yes, that's all you had to give me.
Hello, hey.
Yes, Kevin. Lean into it.
Hello, hey. Don't know one word.
Yes, you don't need
hey,
it.
Hey. Yeah, this is on. Mosquito Dorito. Hey, we're home,
Come on, Kevin.
Boy, we in the bank. We got three people in front of us in line. Homes, I got my paycheck. I got $72 for Burger King. I can't wait to go and buy some movie tickets. Yo, you want to know my song? Hold on. You want to know my... Hold on. Creed, yeah, hush up now.
They're all the same. Red Hot Chili Pepper. I can't hear the difference.
No,
between.
You know the song, but who did it is... That's
up
to y'all.
That's what I'm saying. I don't know.
You want to talk about... When I went to UW, this song came out. My roommate used to play this. I was like, man, this song is dumb.
And man,
boy,
addicted?
When I tell you about the fourth time...
Did they get you?
Boy, Angel!
What song is this?
This is Superman, Five for Fighting. It sounds like you would hear it on Dawson's Creek or Gilmore Girls
definitely
or Party
Dawson's
of Five.
Creek.
I can't stand to fly.
I don't know this song.
I'm not that naive.
Chad.
Men must sound the
high. Oh, man.
I don't think I can do this anymore.
The better part of
this
me.
This is a breakup scene.
I'm more than a bird. I'm more than a plane.
Thank you for all the years.
More than some silly thing. It's out of train.
But it's time
it's
I go.
Not easy to be me.
But Jessica, I can't.
Wish that I could fly. You never heard this?
Never.
This is big Seattle. I don't even
it
expect
it. It feels very Seattle.
Oh, it's raining. I've got my little hoodie on.
Wait for the hook. Wait for the hook.
I never see.
But Jessica, I love you. Chad, I can't do this anymore.
Chad, I can't do this anymore.
I can't. I'm leaving for school. I've got to do what's best for me.
And it's not easy
but just
to be me. Here it is, Angel. Up, up, and away, away from here. But it's all right. We can all sleep sound tonight. Cause I'm not crazy.
Never heard this.
All right, this is the last word.
They got real
I'll do
piano. This.
I'll do my whole, all my white people song the whole time. You want to talk about song that had me on a chokehold with Year Our Lord and Savior 1999?
Why do I know this?
You know this,
is it Backstreet? Oh my God.
This song would this not let me go.
Kevin's in Seattle looking at fireworks, no, crying his heart out to this song.
With you, I was in El Paso. He put his hand on the glass.
Yeah.
No, Ben Affleck. I'll save you, Bruce Willis. Liv Tyler, I'm white.
As Will's with
we gotta get to the bridge. The bridge is where they really go off.
Yeah.
This when Steve was going off.
On a cold night, I love the joy of the that's what they said.
The rest of the time.
Yeah. 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 I don't want to close my eyes.
Bruce.
I don't want to fall.
You're going to burn.
Because I miss you, babe. And I don't want to miss a thing. Cause even when I dream again.
Okay, last one for sure.
Dream will never do.
Why were the lighters in the air ever
this is the last one.
Okay, last go one. Ahead.
Burning butane, so we got a hole in the ozone. The bass,
this is my song from when I had Guitar Hero.
Uh-huh.
This is the song we would sing when we was
I
at,
hear the beginning.
When we was at Finney's. Black folks love these songs.
Wait for the drum intro.
Rock Band, yeah, that was the name of the
drugs,
game.
Man.
Thank you.
Bon Jovi.
Jimmy can ride new head.
That, but why do they all sound like they're yelling?
Oh, it was Tommy.
On the docks.
The same Jimmy.
Hold on, I've never seen the music video for this.
It's just a Jimmy concert.
Oh.
Well,
you gotta play Dream On. Kev, you gotta play Dream On after
Gina.
This. She's the one in the docks?
The diner.
Oh.
Why are you doing that? We gotta hold on to what we've got. Doesn't make it different.
Oh, choir gotta come in hot for this one.
We got each other, and that's a lot.
Everybody.
We'll give it a shot. Oh, we're halfway there. Oh, living on a prayer. Take my hand. We'll make it, I swear.
Oh, living on a prayer. Begin to turn it down, Kevin. Because some of you all are living on a prayer with your finances. And you're looking at your account. And you said, how am I going to get that wedding gift?
How are you going to get it, Angel?
How am I going to pay for this expensive gas?
New gas is high.
Well, Dave is here at the dock. If you download the app, you can get 500 instantly with extra cash. It's a banking app, oh yeah. When expenses come up, oh, finally tackle those expenses.
Hey!
That is the Johnson, you are no interest or credit check needed. Millions of people already downloaded Dave the App. So if you're in a pinch and you need some extra cash, download Dave, cause it's your future, you will thank you. Let me give you the call of action. Pop, 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 pop. Download the Dave app.
Download!
App store, that's D-A-V-E. Account, get $500 instant cash. For terms and conditions, go to dave.com/legal. Instant transfer fees apply. Dave provided by Evolve.
Pay us FBI twice, Dave.
No, we are never getting
that. Future you will thank you.
Nobody on your podcast group of people has ever gave you a Bon Jovi.
Oh, no.
In stream.
Come on.
And without missing a beat, Dave.
All of the things that you asked me to say. D-A-V-E.
Man, Angel, what else are you cooking up? Because we're not done.
We are. We aren't cooking up.
Just do the voice after the song before they go to the next
song. I'm
going to
give you a little Sarah Burrell. Green Chef is a CCOF certified meal kit company. Green Chef, it makes eating well easy with plans to fit every lifestyle. Whether you're keto, paleo, vegan, vegetarian, gluten-free, is looking to eat more balanced meals is you. Green Chef's offers a range of recipes.
You steal the meal.
You steal the meal, 24 recipes weekly with options to mix and match meals from different preferences.
Steal the meal.
Customize your meals with USDA circular organic ground beef and other organic meats. Do you like Green Chef?
Yes, I do. Is that it?
Yes, he does. Because it makes eating so healthy so easily. You see, Kev is so thin over here. But truly, Green Chef has all the options for every lifestyle. Keto, paleo, vegetarian, vegan, fast and fit, Mediterranean, gluten-free. Fit meals under 700 calories and ready in 25 minutes or less. Green Chef is the only meal kit that has both carbon and plastic offset. We offset 100% of our carbon footprint as well as 100% of the plastic in every box. With Green Chef, you're reducing your food waste by at least 23% versus grocery shopping. So, as I said before, you can customize it with USDA certified organic ground beef, USDA certified organic chicken, and wild caught sockeye salmon. Green Chef is now owned by HelloFresh, and with a wider array of meal plans to choose from, there's something for everyone. I know I love being able to switch between the different brands, and you now can do it with a discount on us. Go to greenchef.com/SK135.
SK135.
And use code SK135.
SK135.
To get $135 off across five boxes and get your first box, and your first box ships free. Again, go to greenchef.com/SK135.
135.
And use code SK135.
SK135.
To get $135 off across five boxes and get your first and your first box ships free. Green Chef, that's the number one meal kit for eating well.
Number one meal kit for eating well. Last song, then we're moving on.
This is Journey. This is a little like newer though, right? I know they played the crap out of this. Just a dog town girl.
You better sing, Angel, and come in, right?
Living in a dandy world.
1981.
Better come in, Angel.
81.
Yeah, you know, oh. I just.
That's, I was one. Anywhere. Glee brought this song back.
Glee?
Yes. Don't need my. Just a midnight drink going anywhere. No, come on. Bum, lift up your hands and give the Lord a praise. Yes. Up and down the boulevard, shadows. Where are they doing? Searching in the night. The street lights, come on. Street lights and the people. People living just to find. Living under fine emotion. Hiding, hiding. Oh, somewhere in the night. What's crazy is it takes them forever to get to what the actual hook is. The hook doesn't come in until the end.
Don't stop!
Here we go. It's about to come after that. Cut off! Stop! Cut! Believe it! Oh. Hold on to the feeling!
You better get up there and walk it down.
Come on. People! Don't stop! Woo! Oh! Yes! Do it again!
Oh!
You!
I did it twice, Angel.
You did all set and you came down to that chest voice.
All right, this is the last one, then we move it on. We can't do a whole episode of singing white songs.
Wow.
Tommy, really? Hart, no,
this ain't it.
Take me down.
This is not. That's not it either.
Paradise City.
Yeah, that's my other song. Okay. That's Guns N' Roses. Take me down to the Paradise City where the grass. Okay, we'll do one more.
To be fair, this had the same drums.
It does. A lot of them start off.
They had the. Oh, okay.
This poured some sugar on me.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
This is poured. This is skating rink.
They did every drug available.
Ready. Your man.
Well, we got ads on this one because we're not making a dime.
Oh, we giving them money. Oh, yeah. I gotta pay them $200 after this. I gotta give them cash. Just to be able to post this. Give it to us, Angel. Give us the rock singer.
Oh, no.
That's what it is.
And they were killing.
That's the lead singer. You gotta hold the mic, Angel. That lead singer held the mic and did that.
Put some sugar on me.
Literally how they all did, John.
It was like this rockabye baby with their feet. It was like what Genuine was trying to do.
Oh, when he did that? Okay, last one, I promise. That was perfect, Angel.
That's how they move.
Now, I was in El Paso, Texas, when this song came out. This was my freaking jam. I don't know why I knew this song. Why do I know? We know so many rock bands.
Yeah.
We know their music.
Yes. I went through a white girl phase, though.
Did you?
Me and Sheryl Crow, we were best friends.
To the Paradise City where the grass is green. Girls are pretty.
Take me down the path.
Take me up. He's literally doing what you just did. Literally, he's literally doing it in the video.
Do it, Kevin. Do
it. Come on, Kevin.
Take me home. Then they'll go here, Angel.
Yeah, you gotta swirl the hips to let the groupies know I can swirl my hips.
The white hair.
Yeah.
I'm Axl Rose.
You gotta have the hair, man.
GNR.
You gotta have the hair.
Guns and Roses, baby.
So your tresses can run through the lines of cocaine.
All right, I'm gonna be hot.
You gonna be hot? I am hot. I am sweating. I luckily put on extra deodorant right before we started.
This episode is brought to you by naturaldeodorant.com. Mm-mm. So Capitol Records, this is interesting. Oh, Capitol Records signed their first AI virtual rapper, FN Mecca. The rapper commented on, because Lil Duval posted this and was like, y'all might as well give up. Robots are taking over rap. And FN Mecca has a song called Florida Water. I don't know. Let me listen to it.
Florida Water.
Oh, it's with Gunna.
Yeah. And I'm another surprised. Rapper.
Wait, there's a music video? Gunna? It must have been. It was before.
I mean.
Can't be after.
Can't be during. He's in there now.
This is Gunna and FN Mecca. I know they threw a bag at Gunna to do a rap with a.
Okay, you gotta tell me where the AI person is.
I'm about to tell you.
This is Gunna.
This is Gunna.
Pat.
You create it. You don't necessarily sign. Like Capitol made this rapper.
Where's the robot?
What's his name? What's the robot's name?
FN Mecca.
Gunna's kind of skating on this, though.
FN Mecca?
FN space Mecca.
Cup no lean. Are you on the one that had, does it look like this?
Mm-mm.
Let me see.
I don't see FN Mecca rapping.
Hold on. Let me see what I find. Hold on. Give me a second. So you said this
turbo?
That's him, right? That's Gunna. Where he started?
That's FN Mecca. Yeah, yeah. I'm doing my little Uzi thing, Josh.
The beat's kind of crazy. This beat's kind of crazy.
Okay, FN Mecca.
He said, touch a little coochie.
I thought he said Tesla Gucci.
He could have said that too. Pop it.
Gunna can make a hook though.
So what is it's a person doing the voice.
I don't know.
Who is the rapper?
Like, I don't know if it's a person. They might have fabricated the voice.
It's a full robot?
I don't know.
Well, you remember the monkey people? When there's somebody?
Monkey people?
Come on now. Get into my brain.
The gorillas.
Milli Vanilli?
The gorillas. Stop it.
Is that right?
Oh, the gorillas.
Feel good.
Didn't they? Weren't they just a cartoon?
No, I think they're actually, band.
But did they?
Because they've gone on tour.
Oh, have they? But wasn't there some people that were just a cartoon?
The gorillas, all their music videos were cartoons.
Okay. We'll see. I didn't know they went on tour as real people.
That could have been a Gunna song. That would have been a hit.
What are you looking up, Kevin? You're distracted. What?
No, I'm looking up the gorillas. I'm trying to see what the people look like. I don't think I've ever seen the people.
That's what I'm saying.
What do they look like?
They're a cartoon.
But they went on tour, didn't they? In real life? There wasn't a robot. No, they're people. I see them. There's some white dudes.
No, I know the monkeys. I didn't call them the monkeys. No, I said the monkey people.
Wow.
You know what this makes me feel like?
What?
Seeing that there is an AI rapper. That I have a chance.
As what?
A rapper.
That chick Angel is finna have bars.
No, but like, I can be like a vulgar, like female rapper.
Yes.
Just
absolutely. You'd be fine. AI. Listen, I saw a movie on Netflix recently with a tier one actor, and I talked to Kev about this, and I was like, we're gonna be fine.
Some movies be butt sweat.
But a good time. All it needs to be is a good time, Angel. If you're a good
all
time,
it needs to be Angel. Be you'll a be a good time. Time. A you're good time. Funny. You're clever. You have double entendres.
Unruly Cousin should drop an album.
You know what? I was thinking that when I was hearing Kevin sing his hurrah, 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 and I was like, oh, that would be great on a Unruly Cousins EP.
Yeah.
But
where are the beats, Josh?
Okay. What are we talking about next?
Did you go put this on Josh or not?
Man, I've been checking my email for the beats for I don't know how long. Man.
You know.
What do I got to do to get the
beats? you know when you're about to get slapped. But no, it makes me think, oh, yeah, just draw me a cute little girl, a cute little woman that's like.
What would your content be?
It's going to be filth. What are you talking about as a rapper?
Yeah.
It's going to be straight up filth. We talking about nutting. Busting
a nut. Lead
busting
single.
Busting a nut.
Busting a nut. Busting.
First song busting is just gonna be busting. Called
Busting.
Pussy, eat it up. That's what it's gonna be called.
Lick it.
Look at Josh's face. Lick. Yeah.
Eat it up.
Lick it's
it.
Gonna be foul. People are gonna be like, oh my God. Busting and it's gonna just gonna a whole be like, revolution.
Oh my God.
Oh my God, yeah. This is so much.
Big ol'.
Filthy.
Filthy, filthy. Coochie raps like Flo Millie.
With like, there'll be one inspirational in
there. Oh, you got to do a gospel album just to nod to your original roots.
Who's the new girl?
Glorilla?
Glorilla, she's crazy.
Yeah, everybody been talking about her. I ain't heard no music from her yet, though.
Are y'all picking on me?
No. There's really a rapper named Glorilla.
I was like, I'll be like, oh, okay.
No, really. I've been hearing about her. It's Glorilla, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
GLO. She from Atlanta?
I think so. Maybe. Is that the same girl that's got...
Nah, that's...
That's what's her name from the West or something like that. What's the song name?
Mona Leo? Who is it? It's Liz?
Listen, Marcus.
Oh. You look like you weren't sure. I thought we said a post
see.
Up.
That's why I had to step all the way over.
Oh, okay. Glorilla is 22-year-old...
Yeah.
Where is she from? Oh, wait, she got the ski mask on?
Okay. Ski mask it up.
Ski mask the slump god.
Listen, I do. I want
Llama Llama challenge.
I would literally just write the filthiest lyrics, and people be like, God dang. Yeah.
Oh, she from Memphis.
Oh, then you know she about
her
to be
talking.
Her song
is F and F. The stage crew is asking me.
I mean,
the stage crew is saying play F and F.
I don't say that.
No. F and F, let's go.
Play it loud. Angel will love it.
I need to see it.
That's her?
That's Glorilla. This song got people in a chuckle.
I did not know this was her.
Play the song loud for Angel. We're already not monetizing today.
Is that little skinny bitch?
I didn't know this was this song. I heard this on TikTok.
Oh, this is crazy.
Wow. Her voice is deep.
Yeah.
This is you, Angel. This girl is fully pregnant in this video.
Oh, yeah.
These are regular women. These aren't vixens. These are her.
No.
She was twerking with the full baby stomach out.
You seeing scars and everything.
That's commitment.
You know what's interesting about TikTok, like songs you know from TikTok?
You don't ever hear the full song.
Never. Yeah. So, did you know that Lizzo song? I was reading an article about this. Actually, I saw a TikTok about it.
That one?
What's that?
Her last big one that was on there.
In a minute, I'm gonna need a cinnamon.
Is that the same one?
Yeah, I was singing the rest of the song.
Okay. That song was a flop. Okay?
Oh.
Came out, Lizzo pushed it, bombed. She performed it on Saturday Night Live. Like, first day, dropped out of the first top 100. Went on Saturday Night Live, they're like, oh, performing there, it'll go up. Dropped out of the top 200 after Saturday Night Live. She's also, like, I don't know why people thought Saturday Night Live would save the world.
Right.
They got to stop believing in traditional television.
Lizzo moved on to her next single. The label was like, this is a flop. Yeah, like, go to the next single. So she did. A TikTok person made a dance to, in a minute, I'm going to need a cinnamon, man, a woman, to pump me up. The song came back into the top 150, top 100. Then it was like a top 10 hit or something like that. It wasn't even Lizzo and them people. Just because TikTok.
The dance.
Just because of that doggone dance. Mm-hmm. People didn't even realize that was the same song she was promoting, because that's, I don't think that's the chorus. I don't know what the chorus is.
No. That's the beginning of a song, I think.
I think, no, that's
the beginning
like the
of the
second,
verse. That's the beginning
of the second
like
verse.
Oh, the second verse.
Yes. What is that song called, though?
In a minute, I need a man or woman to pump me up. Dollars, cash racks, cheeks, oranges, some of them.
It's about dang time.
It's about dang time. In a minute.
I'm going to need a sentimental man or woman to pump me
up. She said it's thick 30. That's hilarious. I like Lizzo. Her name's Melissa.
Yeah, that makes sense.
She's from Minnesota.
Minnesota. It's a boot.
Bobby Generic.
It's a boot.
I'm sorry. Dean, did you know Shania Twain is Canadian?
Yeah, absolutely. That's how. Nice. She's a great musician.
Apparently, her husband cheated on her with her best friend.
What?
That's why. Yeah, his name was Mutt Lang.
So they do.
And he wouldn't act like a mutt.
That sound like a man.
And she was nervous because she was like, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do this album, because he had did the first two Diamond albums, and then her last one.
He was her producer.
Yep. And the last one she did by herself, Up, and it went Diamond 2 without Mutt Lang. Mutt Lang is about a country rock producer name.
Mutt sounds
the name
like porn.
Mutt Lang. Yep, cheated on her with her best friend.
Well, let me tell you, today's episode is sponsored by PayPal Honey. That's what we're going to talk about, huh?
And PayPal Honey?
Yes, PayPal, you heard honey. What I said. Already know two of my favorite things.
Is that why PayPal's thing is yellow now?
Listen, I don't know nothing about that, but I love that my best friends are now best friends. What's your favorite thing to shop for online, Josh?
I love to shop for golf accessories online, but not at full price.
Is it easy to find deals?
No, it is not.
Because you know why?
Why?
Because they're not trying to make it easy, but PayPal Honey is here to make things great, because a lot of times you don't be having your promo code ready at checkout. Thanks to Honey, manual searching for coupon codes is a thing of the past. Honey is the free shopping tool that scours the internet for promo codes and applies the best one it finds to your cart. It supports over 30,000 stores online, ranging from tech, gaming, products to popular fashion brands and even food delivery. Let me tell you.
Tell me, Angel.
I like saving money. I don't care how much money I make in life. I feel so good when I see that, your promo code has been applied. You just saved 20%. Let me tell you, you want to tickle my ivories, huh? You want to get me razzle dazzled? Help me save money. And that's what Honey said that they could do. I'm talking about tech. I'm talking about furniture, decor, all the things you could ever want or need. Let me tell you how it works. Imagine you're shopping on one of your favorite sites. When you go to check out, the Honey button drops down, and all you need to do is click apply coupons. Wait for a few seconds as Honey scours the searches for coupons it can find for that site. If Honey finds a working coupon, you'll watch the prices drop. If you don't already have Honey, you could be straight up missing out. It's literally free and installs in a few seconds. And by getting it, you're doing yourself a solid and supporting this podcast. I never recommend something I don't use.
Get you sure Honey don't, Angel. That's the truth.
For free at joinhoney.com/crew with a K.
Crew with a K.
That's joinhoney.com/crew with a K.
Crew with a K.
You better sing.
All right, moving on. This is really interesting to me. Idris Elba's daughter failed to land a role in Beast because their chemistry wasn't right, and they didn't talk for 3 weeks after. I said, what kind of father doesn't utilize his nepotism?
Right.
I was flabbergasted. Do you think Francis Ford Coppola was going to make sure Nicolas Cage didn't get something? Sofia Coppola was a baby in The Godfather. You think they ain't getting in? Judd Apatow make sure his wife and his daughter Maude was up in his movies.
Right. Yeah.
Without those, we wouldn't have got National Treasure.
No. Without the Coppolas, and Nick Cage want to separate himself from his dad.
Unreal.
Denzel ain't never been in no movie with John David.
It's true.
John David got to go get it on himself. He said he was going to drop the last name. Boy, is you crazy?
Yeah, that's kind of wild.
I think it's a...
Don't get things on your own accord. Mm. Make it easy.
It's the reason why they work so hard.
Yes. I want Zay Zay to get stuff over someone more qualified. Preferably white.
I Everybody was like, great, nepotism finally didn't work in this business. This is not the time.
Not for us.
No, this is not the time.
No, it always stops working for us.
I'm like, what? This is not a good thing.
Somebody I want to walk Zay Zay and JoJo and hello, Marcus. I want to walk Zay Zay and JoJo into a podcast company and say, my sons want a podcast and you're going to pay them the ads that you deserve or I walk.
Yeah.
I'm gonna leverage myself.
I don't care if my children have no talent.
I don't care if my children's eyeballs fall out and their butt is sewn together.
That's what I say, their lips sewn together. For my kids, they can't even talk. They have to do like this. I'd be like, yes, of course they're the podcast host.
Listen, LeBron James already put it out into the atmosphere that he wants to play with his son, Bronny, before he retires. His son, if he skips high school, is probably 2 years away from the NBA.
If he skips high school?
I mean, if he skips, actually, it doesn't matter if you skip college or not. If he does 1 year of college or G League, he's 2 years away. I think he's a junior. Is that Bronny? Bronny,
yeah. He's a junior now, right?
Yes. And also, the baby, Bryce, is taller than him now. He's almost as tall as LeBron. He's like 6'5", 6'6".
Jesus.
LeBron James has advanced nepotism set up.
Yeah.
He's going to, by saying you'll get me if you draft my son, you're guaranteeing draft Bronny, you get Bron. Even if he's not good anymore, he going to sell some seats. He going to sell some jerseys. He's going to do a boost.
Yeah.
They could go to the Tupelo, Mississippi Grand Wizards of the Klan basketball team.
Yes.
And wear a Confederate flag jersey.
And it's going to be amazing. Everybody would watch and cheer and root them on. He said they didn't have chemistry. He on some other mess.
Apparently he's not people are making excuses in the Patreon comments. He's just an actor. He's just something else. Somebody
Idris Patreon Elba.
Said, find the chemistry. Jessica Williams said, find the chemistry.
Absolutely. Who cares? We got the biology though. If we ain't got the chemistry, we got that. We got the physics. We got all the other sciences that work together.
Everything.
When you are Idris, you are never just an actor. When you are Denzel Washington, you're never just an actor. First of all, there's very few films that they will sign up to be on that they're not a producer as well.
Nowadays.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So it's not people saying he's just the actor. He is no longer in that lane anymore. Anything these men are in that like these are top tier black actors, they are also, unless it's maybe Marvel.
Unless it's Marvel. If it was a Thor movie, they'd be like, Idris, now hush up and take this check. Yeah,
but if it's one of these movies that you
Beast?
Know. Beast? Yeah, no. He has a lot of say.
They can get in Beast.
Yes.
I'm so disappointed in you, Idris. Mm-hmm. How are you going to make sure I get in a film if he can't make sure his baby get in one?
Listen. I know. If he look at me too hard one day at a light, I better be in that film. Sir, we had an emotional connection. And you gonna tell me I'm not in it? You done lost your mind. You should have never committed to me at that red light.
Somebody said if she sucks, she sucked. No. Get that baby. I didn't even know Idris Elba had a daughter. Actually,
I do. Because she did. This is how she clapped at her birthday party.
Did she?
Yes. It was so funny. She was like, I think y'all confused on nepotism. Y'all think it has anything to do with talent? No. That's not how it works. You get the talent later, maybe.
Jamie Lee Curtis admitted, she was like, look, I think she got, what was her first big movie? Was it Friday the 13th?
Mm-hmm.
Jamie Lee Curtis?
I think so. It was one of the horror films. Yeah.
Her mom is the lady, if I'm not mistaken, her mom is the lady in the shower scene in Psycho.
Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty sure.
Mm-hmm.
And Jamie Lee, Halloween, yep. Jamie Lee Curtis was like, look, it came down to me and some other girl whose mom was not in Psycho. And I got it. I think her dad is Tony Curtis or something.
Mm-hmm.
She was like, I'm well aware that I am where I am because of my
life. Gwyneth Paltrow, guess who her godfather is?
Who?
Steven Spielberg.
Really?
One day he went up to her. He said, would you be the Wendy in my Peter Pan?
And that's it.
That's how she started her career.
Wow.
She wasn't even an actor before that?
She hadn't been in anything.
Dang, I didn't know she was, I know Spielberg was her, my godfather just worked at the plant. I don't even got a godfather.
Mine is dead. Well, what's he gonna do?
How you gonna get a movie? Y'all got godfathers in the Mexican community?
Ninos.
Ninos?
Yeah, mine works at Northrop Grumman. He's an engineer, actually.
So he can get you a job down in Northrop Grumman?
I could have been set at Northrop Grumman.
Could you imagine, Josh?
Oh, I would.
You work in aerospace? Tinkerbell,
but she was in there.
He takes his lunch when we started this podcast.
That's how I was at Boeing.
I know.
My lunch was at 9:30.
I don't understand. Why did it have to be so early?
Because I start at 5.
No, but why do they do that?
I don't know.
He's like, but I'm home by 2.
The factory is 24 hours.
I'm asleep by 5 then.
I was eating bacon cheeseburgers and Dr. Pepper at 9:17.
Oh, I can't be good for cholesterol.
Yes, Gwyneth got famous parents and Steven Spielberg is her godfather. And y'all think she waited for talent to show up? Mm-mm. No!
Gwyneth Paltrow didn't even know she was in a Marvel movie until they were recording her. She was like, yeah, you know, you was in Spider-Man Homecoming. She was like, no, I wasn't. She was like, it was John Favreau.
John Favreau, who literally produced it.
He was like, yes, you were. She was like, I never shot for that. He was like, do you not remember we shot that scene for Iron Man and we held it and put it in Spider-Man? She was like, I didn't see it in theaters. So you didn't know you was in a whole movie. You didn't getting checks.
Know you got she, right. You didn't know you got the appearance check.
How does that, I thought you had to sign every time.
Just coming in different. I mean, her people probably signed it.
Her business manager is signing this stuff.
She don't sign?
More than likely, no. She's a corporation. So she doesn't have to be the signature.
You know, I want to be in a place in life where I'm in a Marvel film in a post-credit scene and I didn't even know it. That's where I want to be. Mm. Kev, you was in the end of the new Thor, Black Stars Rose.
I was? Your butt was out. You'd be like, that's me.
Oh, I guess it was.
If my butt was out, it was definitely me.
They did one take with you. They're in the post like, guys, Kevin's butt's out. Well, I mean, you got to play it. You got to move up a rating.
That'd be so authentic. If I was a superhero that couldn't keep his pants. If I had a superhero in my pants.
That's your power. Your power comes out of the crack. That's it. Oh, it's cracking showing. Everybody get down.
Kev breaks in the room. It's get cracking.
Yes. Let's get cracking.
I am dad bomb.
That sounds more like something on The Boys than it does Marvel. But still.
Did you watch the new season of that?
Yes, I did. That's why y'all thought old dude wasn't light skinned.
Dog. That's right. The first
Mother's Milk
episode of this current season of The Boys, I saw something no one should ever see.
Talking about with Octopus? What you talking about?
Before that, the first episode when the small man went inside.
Yes, he did. I said, they are so disgusting.
Have you seen it?
I'm going to binge it today.
Josh. Around 11 minutes in on that first episode, you going to question if you need to watch the record.
And I knew exactly what was going to happen. As soon as that, I was like, these people are foul.
Tony Baker said, Kev, watch The Boys, watch the first 11 minutes. And I was like, man, somebody, oh my God.
They said, what can we do that's never been done before? What would be so cringy and so just make you want to take your eyeballs out and put them in the washing machine and then put them back in?
That show gets wilder after that.
Yeah.
Herogasm is just like, Josh.
Herogasm.
Also, Game of Thrones, I said this in my review. They back to full on 30 people orgies.
Oh, yeah.
The good old days. The dude was smashing the woman doggy style. And the dude was like, silence. The prince wants to speak. He stayed in.
I can't tell it.
He left it in like a thermometer. He's like, what's up, like a prince? Thermometer. What's going on? He's just turned around. She looking, he looking. I was like, we back, baby.
That's how incest happens.
No, I know it's not. Crazy in that room.
They'd be like, oh, snap. They'd be like, it's you.
The age of it's okay to have sex, what, 13?
Yeah. That medieval people, boy, that room had to be
just
must. I mean, just disgusting.
It was.
Anyway, we love y'all. We'll see y'all. Patreon, we got to figure that out.
We're going to figure it out, guys.
And the rest of y'all, we've been Patreon. We're going to do Bald and Beautiful after this. Make sure to get your tickets to the Marriage Be Hard book tour. Houston and Chicago are the only ones that are still on sale. Atlanta and D.C. sold out. You can thank the stage crew on Patreon for that. If you want to be able to get to things early, you got to join the Patreon.
It's
real simple. As long as I live, all my tour dates, everything I do, they get, especially if it's going to be a limited quantity, give them the first time. One of the days I gave them about a whole pay period to take their chance.
Man, I'm about to drop more mugs.
Yeah. So we'll see y'all if you all get y'all tickets for Houston and Atlanta. If not, we will see you when I'm on tour next year, and it's going to be crazy. I love y'all. Bye.
Goodbye.
Here's another banger for ya. Here's another one. Here's another banger for ya. Here's another one. Here's another one. Here's another banger for ya. Here's another banger for ya. With my boy Kev on stage. And that chick Angel.